And Mark's boss in the game. That was weird. Corn. Starred River. I sure appreciate all this corn here. It's really nicely modeled corn. It's multiple layers of corn. It's a pretty corny game. If things get a little hot in here, things will really pop. So I've actually played a little bit of this, and by a little bit I mean I usually do like about a 10 minute test run of the game, so I do know where some of the items are, but only like a few of them. Go left. Right now I'm hitting Q. It'll eventually do something, most likely. Back in mysterious minutes. Got an English muffin. A bunch of boxes just randomly flew away. Hard as granite. This muffin is most definitely nowhere near fit for consumption. Despite how much you try, all you've done is given yourself a headache. Nice stump. Hopefully it doesn't stump me later when I do puzzles. Yeah, you can see like some of the items I picked up earlier when I was test running this. Completely useless for shoveling dirt, but helpful if you want to tip something over, like a cow. You mainly think of the wardrobe on the second floor of the farmhouse that you haven't seen yet, because you didn't particularly like how it looked at you. Wouldn't like to ruin its day. This game has a corny sense of humor, ho ho! I know the Colonel wouldn't like this game. He was always a pretty husky dude. Chicken coop. Feeling pretty cooped up here. The mine explodes with the possible use of this item, but you sell on key to unlock a nearby farmhouse, and never think of any other possibility again. Gotta go fast. I think since I found some note items earlier, I think they're permanently in my inventory. Fruit crate. Despite what the name would suggest, this crate was specifically used to hold a large number of pine cones in order to start a collection. The collection currently sits at zero. Corn oil. This particular plug fits perfectly into the bathroom sink on the first floor of the farmhouse. There's also a talking plug, but due to a bad case of laryngitis, you'll never know that. no clippers. Vigilant as you are when it comes to personal hygiene, the only two things these clippers will do for you are grip something lodged in a wall and give you 100% tetanus guarantee. That's it. Unlock secret door, make it much less secret. Open secret door. We need a fuse. Open cellar doors. Okay, still does nothing. For some reason, the first thing that pops in your head is that it would be a good conductor of electricity. Possibly as a fuse. You're very strange. You're the mind of an adventure game protag.
It's rusty nail here. It's gonna be a great fuse. I'm gonna shammer it in over there and it'll work out.
Use rusty nails as a fuse again. Against safety regulations. Restored part of the farmhouse is suddenly less dark than it was before. You guys got any loot? Got some loot I can steal? That's some loot. An old CD, its labels faded. Pressed on the first batch of CDs ever created. And oh god, that thing is gone. This brand was notoriously expensive and even more unreliable. Making even the greatest of symphonies sound like something a concussed elephant would make while stumbling around a music shop. Kinda like this.
Bang, 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 bang.
I'm an elephant.
Bang.
And that's not me trying to say I'm an elephant. That's the elephant saying he's an elephant, just so you know. It's part of the impression. I'm just parodying myself at this point. Pin. Extremely useful for picking a lock, but you mistakenly found it was a pencil and wrote a very detailed account of your day up to that point. I didn't notice there was no ink until a few hours later. That's how you feel if your recording goes bad when you're a Let's Player. It's probably the music that reminds you of Subnautica. What do they mean? Man. It's the world's ugliest gnome. So I'm just smashing something perfectly flat with this trusty tool. But remember, you can never unflan things with this. It's a mallet's greatest weakness. Okay. Go to the barn. It's gonna be loads of fun. Guess what the guy's name was who lived in the barn? Barney. He was a dinosaur, by the way. Didn't know if you knew that. He got his life started in barns, you see. It's before he got his job in that TV show. Yep, Barney. Barney lived in that barn. In that barn for a good 2 or 3 years. till the children started disappearing. Started with little old Tim down by the old gas station, and then little Marcy, then little Jack and Jill. They started going missing one after the other, but no one could pin down where they happened. But we know. My family always known and keep it secret. So one old day we come out to the barn and check up on Bonnie. And we find a little kid's shoes buried under the haystack. Just like this glove. Now what would old Barney do with old little kid's shoes, makes you wonder. That's when we found it. Barney was already gone by the time we went back to the house. He probably knew his days were numbered, got out of town when he could. We took what remained and buried it out in the backyard. Talked about never talking about this ever again. Last we ever saw Barney, the one day he showed up on the old TV. Back in black and white, no color TV yet. If only they knew what they unleashed. There's a pile of something or other you can sweep up with this, but you already know that. But you didn't know that this room is haunted. So it's not affect your adventure in any way, as the ghost is currently away on business. Like the padlock with the bobby pin. Let's sweep this up. Neil knows pliers. You saw something that sausage grinder could be removed with these pliers. You know it's because you spent an uncomfortable amount of time trying to pull it off your hands, making no progress whatsoever. There's secrets in here. No, the ghost haunts the broom, see? So it's more like you're taking his house. He comes back from vacation. And he's just like,
hey man, where'd my house go? What? It's not cool, man. I'm dead.
Hands off. A severed hand, perfectly preserved in the glove that encases it. It could come in handy. If you could give yourself a hand and find a way to loosen and get the glove off. The first pun was intended, but not the second. Hey, there's a hat. Charred name tag. It took you several hours of staring, but you managed to deduce that the name tag in fact belongs to the dead person who was near. And his name is Fernando. It took several more hours to notice that the dead person was a lab assistant, and then 5 more minutes to realize you were trying to read the thing upside down the whole time. A very fashionable fedora. Ooh. A very fashionable fedora worn by a very fashionable person. Tip. Due to this, you are not putting on your head, as you have not earned the right. On the inner tag, the owner wrote his name. Fernando. It's a toolbox there. Looks like he got fried, maybe. He got too greedy, dug too deep. I wonder if this hand would be of use in the barn. This is about where I played to. When I was testing out the settings of this game, so from here on out, I'm not sure what I'm quite doing. Me, Colonel. There's a glove here, and there's a hat. It's kind of weird, right? Oh, I know what this is for. Put the hand on the thing and scan the handprint. But you gotta take the glove off. Oil. The oil in the tub takes the glove off the hand. Where's the kitchen at? Heyo, heyo. Losing the glove from the severed hand. Slightly disgusting. Once you manage to tear away from giving yourself an unending stream of high fives with this hand, you may want to find actual use for it. That's not to start another round of high fives. Warp key. This warp key FOB could be useful if you could flatten it back to its original shape. At first you tried to do this by staring very hard at it. Didn't work. So you set out to find a tool that would do the job much better. The question is, what's the biscuit for? Everything else has a logical thing with a biscuit. The key FOB has been smashed so perfectly flat that you can't but toss it like a frisbee to see how far it goes. You regret your decision immediately.
What's the English muffin for? What does it mean?
We go back to the door and open it. Oh boy. I'm amazed by this maze. No, really. It's amazing. Top secret. You did it! I like that music.
Hey!
Oh, hi.
You must answer a riddle before you're allowed to enter.
To answer corn.
A doctor and his son are in a car accident.
No, not that one. Say the one about the guy who hung himself with an ice block. You just gave that one away. Answer this one. What animal walks on four legs in the morning?
That one's boring! I'm riddle president today. I get to pick.
Answer was man.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Why is he president every time?
No, about you. I've been a vote unclear for him on the election.
Oh, we should just yesterday.
An empty bus pulls up to a stop and 10 people get on. At the next stop, 5 people get off, and twice as many people get on as at the first stop. At the third stop, 25 get off. So, which one of us is named Jim?
You.
Am I Jim? I thought he was Jim.
No, that's Bill.
Where's Bill?
You're Bill.
Oh, that's right.
You may as well enter as we sort this all out. Let's hope you're better than the last one.
They have a corny sense of humor, do you get it?
Oh, and watch out for our brother down there. He's a bit odd.
What did I do with the biscuit? Mom, I told you to fix these elevators weeks ago. It takes hours for everyone to get in here and because of your stupid experiment, moron. Ted. Hiya, Ted. Don't worry about it. I'll reset the elevator after a few more months of data. We overbought in food pellets and had to get rid of them somehow. Bomb. You press the button. You ate a stale pellet. Guys. You press the button. You ate a stale pellet. You ate a pellet. This guy's really popular. I think he's dead, probably, or he became corn.
My gold bulb! What is this? Did you actually have the gall to commission a bronze statue of yourself? It costs us a fortune, you narcissistic dolt.
Hiya, Ted. Don't worry, I got a good deal on it. Commission these statues in a bulk. Think that really sprues up the facility, especially for the tour. Could be a big moneymaker for us.
Bob, you're so, so very stupid. What about the term classified, don't you understand? Can't host any tours, moron. And I don't think you didn't know she put one near the farmhouse. Repeat, classified. Put away, idiot.
A facility brochure. Welcome to the future is corn. A flashy brochure that appears to be part of the proposed tour of the facility, which includes what Bob thought a modern child looked like. Most of the brochure is redacted, except for the walking sentient corn on the front. Bob P. McTavish, Honorary Lobby. Ted S. Bob and Ted. Door number one closed.
Hiya, Ted. The Ash. Fish shipment should be arriving today. Could you be a pal and put them in the fanks for me? Thanks.
Bob, you dummy. There are thousands of water tanks here. Do you realize how much feeding these fish will cost?
I don't see any fish in the tanks.
What's the boxes? There's so many cardboard boxes.
Ted, exciting news. I got us a huge deal in jumpsuits for the facility. I got thousands in bulk at the fraction of the price. Or to use the savings for some great stuff.
Bobby, you idiot. You got a good deal on them because they are completely useless. Nobody can wear them.
You know, material that looks like will fall apart the mere thought of a gentle breeze. This jumpsuit should not be worn by anyone. Hey yo. Coat rack. Good for hanging coats, unless it's placed upside down, in which case it's not effective at all. That's a clue. We set power mode active. Welfare readiness report. Appears to be a report on warfare readiness to the subjects of the Project Mazu. The report states multiple times that the sentient corn had no discernible method of raising or operating a military firearm, and have a habit of taking naps right in the middle of the test. The term abject failure also appears all over the document, a running theme on many reports involving the corn. Oh, Franken pizza. Gonna poke some things with my good old poking stick pretty soon here. Gotta paste a teddy bear here.
Bob, stop playing your stupid games on my computer. It's screwing up the AI experiments, idiot.
We gotta put a keyboard here. English muffins don't work. Can't use a keyboard. We can't use the English muffin as a replacement keyboard.
Bob, you disgusting slob. Oh, do you know how to stop read? Stop eating in here, you glutton.
There we go. As the name suggests, this computer is old. You get a sense that it could use an upgrade, and then you spend several moments trying to figure out what the word upgrade means. The Gripoton. Like every model, this Gripoton contains the innate ability to be unable to grasp anything of value with its claws.
Bob, you jerk. Put my RAM back where it was. I know you took it and hid it in that stupid spot of yours. Bring it back here.
It appears to be an official guidebook for a tour of the research facility. A large portion of the text inside has been redacted, but 20 pages are fully dedicated to the giant vats. And mostly repeat the refrain that the vats are very large and contain things that should stay in very large vats.
Hi, Ted. The latest brochure came back from the press. Take a look. I think it'll really boost the tour. You'll be happy to know that the most sensitive bits have been redacted. Safety first.
Bob, first you're an idiot. The brochure is incredibly stupid. Second, the last time, no tools. Third, if you're going to make the stupid brochure, at least add my name to it. We're co-research heads, remember? It's the same title, jerk.
Hi, Ted. Really sorry, but the final print has been done and sent off. I'll make doubly sure the next one has your name underneath mine on the front.
Good God, Bob. Do you have a reading comprehension of a 5-year-old? The top secrets of facility. Did you send those brochures, you moron?
Hoyo, hoyo. So we need something else. Let's put a computer there. We'll be back in this area. No grotto. Oh man, this is nice. There's corn staring at me, but this is nice. Really tasteful. I'm really liking the aesthetic here. This corn look at me, but I'm really liking the aesthetic. Originated from a local fast food restaurant. The nutritional information on the wrapper proudly proclaims now 100% salmonella free. There are no exaggeration, thousands of these wrappers are living in the facility. The very fetching mustard scene, this particular one sparked you to pick it up. Oh, this was a Napoleon. But yeah, this is really tasteful. It's really nice. Hey, Ted. Notice that you took down the painting in the lobby. Thanks. And a little blemish on it. No sweat, though. Here's another one. Be a pal and put up, would you please? Wow. Bob, I'm not putting up another one of your paintings on you yourself, you indulgent loose. For God's sake, how many did you order? Why is my face on that stupid horse? Because you're a horse's ass. I'm not even joking. Latex gloves. Man, they were eating a lot of food down here. Hey, what's this? Bobby, disgusting slob. To clean up after yourself, I'm blocking your entrance to the bathroom. I'm tired of calling in the hazmat team every week, moron. Oh, wow. Oh, wow, Bob. Looks like Bob had a lot of fun. He had some really, really good drunken ping pong going on here. Small screwdriver. Bob's favorite screwdriver used to pry open Bob's secret storage spot. It's completely useless for moving screws, but makes a nice ping noise when tapped against a metal railing. Military backpack. It can carry lots of things, none of which come to mind at this particular moment. That's for the teddy bear set up. Wasn't there corn in here? Maybe it was there in the other window. Yeah, they were in the other window. Okay.
Let us pose another query. If a tree falls in the woods, does it make a sound?
Interesting conundrum. What kind of tree?
Fir.
Can it talk?
Yes, but only after lunchtime.
Is it wearing a lot of bells?
Some, but not many.
Is it in a glass house?
Naturally.
I have it. It does make a sound, but since it's a tree, it's too stupid to notice.
Correct!
Well done.
But what if the tree can't hear? Does it still make a sound? I'm not paying for this. The invoice for this incredibly extravagant bathroom calls for marble steps leading up to two F-craft toilets, and a sink encrusted in gold. Cost is hundreds of thousands. Ted left it on Bob's toilet seat with a very poignant statement on financial culpability. It's nice stuff. Nice stuff. Oh man, the Sketcher 3000, I love these.
A major improvement over the Sketcher 2000, and it features the ability to actually draw lines instead of instructing children to stare at the screen and imagine the drawing in their minds. You feel like using it to draw a large face, owing to your fascination with foreheads.
My main character is into the type of anime girls, with large foreheads and glasses. I wonder. What's the English muffin for? English muffin like come and use like the finale of the game. You save this entire item this entire time for this very specific reason.
Legendary English muffin of Narnia. Copyright not intended.
Hiya, Ted. Just heads up. I'll put your RAM right here. The way it gets less dusty, Bob. RAM for the computer. Oh, it's a workout area. It's pretty nice. A lot of small weights being used. It's a dumbbell. Get it? Try as you might, you are unable to lift this more than 2 times in quick succession. Yet somehow you continue to carry it with wherever you go. Sweaty headbands could be useful. The sweaty headband imbues the wearer with the ability to walk at a slightly brisker pace than normal for short periods of time. It's not worth the risk. The only way this report could sound more triumphant is if temperature blared every time it was read. It explains a very promising result after examining one of the new sentient corn stalks, a breed of ruby queen corn that shows high levels of intelligence. It also glosses over the fact that the specimen is somehow female, which was apparently impossible under the genetic protocol officially used to create them. Someone smashed the wind mirrors because they can't render mirrors because they take up too much processing power. All the mirrors. Adam Jensen came in here and just did this for them. He was like, I'll take care of those mirrors for you. A run-of-the-mill rock with no defining features whatsoever. To discern from the billions of our rocks currently in existence, his name is Mabel. Let's go, Mabel. No relation to a certain cartoon show. Mabel! This area is nice. Secretly, this scarecrow's dying in the inside. Because he's listening to nothing but corn puns. How did I do? You're going to have a ball. Oh boy. There's a nondescript children's block adorned with the letters and numbers you spend a long time trying to figure out which is which. Eventually sort out, but the number 5 still fools you every now and then. A Soviet knockoff of famous American teddy bear, which says a variety of friendly Russian sayings when powered up. Is named Vladi, according to the tag. Looks grump.
Bobby, lazy buffoon. Are you spending all your time here not signing the giant stack of paperwork I left at your desk? Stop playing with your toys and do your job. And also, for the thousandth time, why do we even have a daycare? There are no children here, half-whiffed.
We're all children on the inside, man. Maybe we just have some growing up to do. Okay, we got some good items here. We can do a lot of work. Put the RAM in. Put the bear. We need to put something there. Oh, there we go.
What? What are you looking at? Something on Vladdy's face? Why you no talk?
Do you understand?
Understand what Vladdy is saying? Butso boy, you're a big idiot. How you survive by being stupid?
Yes.
Fine.
No.
Vladdy help. Why guy so minoy? What is this on Vladdy's back?
It's useless.
This makes no sense.
I know.
All of this is very stupid.
I know.
So, where do we go?
I don't know. I'm very stupid. You acquired Vani. Prepare to be insulted forever.
We need you to settle a debate on taking naps. Oh my god. What is that?
What is Plant saying?
Is that a...
It is.
It's a helicopter!
What? Da?
Give me a ride, Mr. Helicopter!
No, give me a ride!
We can all fit just climbing!
My lucid drug! What's the way? Boy grisomnyoy! Chitanya Vesulo!
What a rude contraption! action.
Well, if you're just gonna be like that.
Oh, right. We completely forgot. We have a message for you.
It's very important.
You should hit the showers.
What's a shower?
I have no idea.
Let's hit those showers.
Everybody does not like it here.
Whatever the twist is in, I'm gonna be corn. Let's go, Vladdy. Let's go a little bit faster, buddy. Come on, you can do it. I believe in you. I believe in you, buddy. You'll get there eventually. Oh boy. Let's hit those showers. Vladdy, did what?
While you do your stupid things, idiot.
Okay.
Don't put the pumpkin.
The red line wants me to go here, but I like to spray off the path because I'm a rebel. I'm a little too rebellious. Gotta keep to my standards.
It should be me! It should be me! Surrounded by idiots! Rattle! Underappreciated! Ridiculed! Scorned! Really, what is that? X is not a number. What? Why is that there?
Are you Ted?
We should have kept one around to ask about that. X's. Ugh! Ridiculous!
Oh god, he's got a fanny pack.
Much better. Some of my best work. Was it saying something? What was I doing? Oh yes! Dealing with unwanted guests!
Good job. He seems nice. This game reminds me a lot more of Oddworld, if anything, like the Oddworld series in general. Very similar humor. God, he's in here.
Where did it go? Not here. Ha! Not here. So insulting. How dare it? This insolence will not be tolerated. This one is dangerous. Not like the others. I can see that already. This one has a brain. Must be dealt with.
What if all mankind's already wiped out by the corn? Come in and knock something over. There you go. Good job. Good job. You get a banana sticker. We don't do corn stickers anymore. It's considered racist. So we made corn of boobs.
We are not amused that you have kept us waiting. As our servant informed you of your task. No, of course not. Imbecile. No matter. One must do things themselves if one would like it done right. Feels like we have been trapped here for an age. Our cowardly captors saw to that, by stopping the righteous light from bathing us in its glory. Of course, we would not expect one such as yourself to understand. But perhaps you are different from the rest. Dare we let ourselves hope that we have finally found our champion? No, likely not. But we would be remiss if we did not at least let you attempt to do something of value. So, we bequeath to you your tasks. Restore energy to this wretched place once again, and raise the rings. Only then will you be worthy of consideration.
You lost me. I gotta walk all the way back. Yes, I do. Oh boy. She's crawling a long way. I found Joe Moore. Crawling through a vent. I'm gonna vent my frustrations a little. Right. I went there. That's what I do. I go there, man. It just way appears and I just go. That's how it is, man. Hey, Vladdy. You still racist? Good for you. Oh, God.
Ah, idiot. So you are done being stupid up there. Good. Where we go?
This way. Comrade? I'll wait for you to catch up, comrade da. My poking stick. Gonna poke some things.
Useless garbage everywhere.
Move me. Are you gonna move this wall all away from me? I guess you like warp behind me. So you can't keep up, but you like warp when I'm not looking. Creepy, man. It's creepo. Well, it's not here. Yellow. Green. Fuchsia. A broken security checkpoint.
Why is that Vladdy's job? What is Vladdy supposed to do?
Do Russian things. Opa!
Thing will never work. It is. Huh? Okay.
You think the edge of sketch would work there? Ah, I gotta make a thing on thing of ominous. Make a scan on the face Mafunga. I'll be back. Vlad, you scare me sometimes. Gotta do it on the portrait.
There are too many containers here. Vladdy does not like it.
You don't like a lot of things, Vladdy. It's a pretty good facial sketch, in my opinion. Okay. Here we go.
That never work.
It'll work.
Well, that was still stupid.
It's a pretty accurate facial description. Hey, look, you opened a door. Vladdy, this place is pretty big. I'm kind of overwhelmed. Let's start here. This is some nice color. Some nice colors right here. I put a room around this color. That's really nice. So we got a secret submarine base. You decide to pick this up because you like the direction of the grain in the wood. And it gives you splinters while holding from every conceivable angle. Oh, great. Instruction manual for building your very own two-man submarine. Since Bob and Ted opted for the budget model, the manual is 800 pages long and mapped on a fashion that is similar to a Choose Your Own Adventure novel. Gotta unlock this. A water pipe. This magic water pipe grants you the power to transport water from one end to the other. There will be no reason for you to do this at any point in this adventure, but you will continue to carry it anyways, just in case. Biscuit? No. Hi, Ted, just FYI, I brought the acetylene gas tank up to the farm. For the annual staff barbecue. Completely corn-free, of course. Ha ha.
Bob, how many times have I told you that we can't have barbecues out on the farm? Put it back. A day behind schedule. And some joyriding of the tractor dummy.
Key for a toolbox, okay. There we go. The cheapest box cutter commercially available. This brand holds the distinction of being the only one that is rendered completely useless after one swipe. Oh, no wonder these things break. For some reason, you feel the urge to break something beautiful with this. Instead of doing the standard task of hammering a nail. You know why you think these things.
Stupid American.
And that puts something there like an egg or something and smash it. Created by Pete's Games and Carnival, the design of the Linden Crane appears to be based off a simple claw game, a factor which aside Bob to no end. Ted conversely wasn't too thrilled about it, but was stuck with it anyway after Bob forged his signature in the approval form. I like Bob. Bob's a real go-getter. He knows what he wants and he gets it. Oh, I didn't know that. Hey, Ted, upgrade the living system so two people could use it at once. Our efficiency will nearly double.
Bob, I know that. Do not say this lightly. This may well be the absolute worst idea you've ever had, idiot.
Is that a guitar? No, it's a cello case.
Bomb for the last time, stop leaving your junk everywhere. I know why you even have a cello case. You don't even own a cello, dummy.
A strange sealed box, it will open up the box cutter. Wow, they really are eggs. Bomb got his hands on these extravagant artifacts because he knew a guy. He bought them in bulk so he could get a slight discount. He kept them even after he learned that they didn't contain any chocolate. Hey, Ted, need this box of knickknacks loaded. Be a pal and move it for me, would ya?
Bob, you're soft. Not your errand boy. Load it yourself.
It's priceless egg. Smash priceless egg. A priceless lockpick.
Easily the most expensive lockpick in the world, but you don't really care because you have no idea how modern economics work. Ellie won't say this, but you prepare to crawl for the vent and lock the door. For reasons unknown only to you, you are holding a very radioactive fuel rod in your hands, ignoring every known safety procedure for proper containment and storage imaginable. Hey Vladdy, you're Russian, you like uranium, right? Go get it.
In there? Oh, butzel boy. Stupid idiot, making Vladdy crawl through dumb thing. What is Vladdy supposed to do in here? Stupid! Stupid wires everywhere! Why is this stupid? Why is this stupid thing upside down?
Sounds like Russian engineering.
No, how stupid are these idiots? Maybe if Vladdy gets... Vladdy has to... Just do this dumb... Boy, guy, so mignon! Hey, idiot! Did that work?
No. Stay there.
Stop being stupid and say something!
Can't talk. I'm corn, probably.
Anyway. Twin my Lucian drugs, stupid idiot. Could get nowhere without Vladdy. Vladdy has to do everything. So, now what?
First, I keep the uranium, because I can't have you have this. So, Vladdy, where is a place where I can go and radioactive? Is it up or down? That's a question in life, isn't it? So it's not this way, it's gonna be lower. Yeah, like someone said, he's supposed to be a knockoff of Teddy Roosevelt. Wow.
Bomb, you buffoon. Why is that lobby here and what happened to the decapitation room?
Oh, it's Ed. Pretty sure I told you. Did a little rework here. Think this will be a real high traffic spot for the tour. Gonna be a real moneymaker.
Words fail me, idiot. And stop with the statues. Bob, I noticed this flower and assumed this was your work. So I remind you, pools are not safe to hold chemical waste. Why'd you order one, stupid?
The flyer for Paul's pools and pest removal advertises big savings for orders within a 20-mile radius of the shop, along with free extermination of one pest. The cheapest pool in the flyer has been circled several times in red pen. You need that coffee maker. You took this not because you want to make coffee, but that you heard that a coffee machine grants you one wish. A wish for a good morning. From a guy named Joe. After much thought, you wished for coffee. It didn't come true. A brochure for a company whose main goal is to fulfill all of your low to mid-level lobby needs. On the back, one design in particular is circled in red pen, the cheapest one. The company tagline reads, "Waiting never felt so good." Oh god. Is it quite possibly the worst written book of guidelines in the history of time? None of the guidelines make sense, and the instruction drawings of a consist of a per-stick person and away from a large fire. It's running away from the folly of man. Bob, I've made this map so our staff can restrict the bargain. Restart the bargain basement reactor you ordered without blowing us all to Kingdom Come. Do me a favor and don't come anywhere near it, moron. Ted, I solved your maze. Took me a little while, but got it in the end.
Bob, how are you stupid? Did you get your doctorate out of a cereal box?
So we gotta stick this fuel rod up somewhere.
Try not to be an idiot in there. It would be very bad.
Quiet, you're Russian. You don't know anything.
You do something stupid.
Shouldn't I be dying right now? What? Why is there a maze in here? It doesn't make sense, boy. Vladdy. Vladdy, you're Russian. Solve this maze for me. God, it was always something those zombies were out. Oh God. This way. We're almost there. Just don't blow up in my face. There we go. You see, Vladdy? It's all okay. The Americans aren't so dumb after all. You did it. Compliment me. You bastard. We started the worst nuclear reactor in the world. We did it! Technically, I did it. You didn't do anything. Fidelity's power status, okay. Cool. Door. We came in through there. So we went down here, made a right. We'll go up now and see if there's anything up here.
It's too dark in here. I can't see a thing. Perhaps if we turned around.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. This is a perfectly nice place to stand.
Well, I can't argue with that logic. Neither can I.
Come on, Vladdy. Ignore the corn.
This stupid thing.
Here, go in this vent for me, would you?
Again with the crawling.
Oh, you love me. Don't you complain.
What is Vladdy doing here? Is this Vladdy's purpose? Crawling and climbing through stupid junk to get more stupid junk? And for what? This stupid garbage? This is useless. No use. No purpose. Just more garbage.
Just throw it to me.
For idiots. Always.
Might be able to combine. Oh, he's dead. Forget him. He's lost.
Garbage. Я тебя люблю. Hope this garbage worth Vladdy's suffering. But I already know the answer. No, because it's garbage! What stupid thing is next?
Vladdy's ready to start hitting vents. The communication area of this particular control console was designed to be removable from its base. It was lost approximately 60 times during the facility's existence. Nice. I have no idea what you're for, but nice. Oh, that makes sense. There's other hooks around the place, too.
So, this is what stupid thing does? Vladdy still think it garbage.
If anything you did was important, probably. This rock has no idea whether it's a rock, a facsimile of a rock, or an amalgamation of many rocks or a non-rock. By picking it up, you have undone all of its conclusion about the world up until this point. You have named it Wallace. Oh, this is useful, actually.
Why do you think you may have problem, idiot? You take too much garbage.
I am enjoying maize. It's a maize-ling. Broke off its door, thanks to a shoddy soldering job, done immediately after the facility Christmas party. You could probably find another door to fit on, too, just not this one.